in this classic striker versus striker matchup. 8 knockouts or technical knockouts between these two opponents. And introducing first, standing on my left and fighting from the blue side of the cage, she is trained as a Muay Thai fighter with good striking skills. At 5'9" tall, she weighed in at an even 135 pounds. Her professional record, 3 wins with 2 losses, 2 of those coming by way of technical knockout. Fighting out of Pleasant Hill, California, ladies and gentlemen, here is Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith.
Smart time, you ask.
Her opponent tonight, fighting from the red side of the cage, also a prolific striker. At 5'9" tall, she weighed in at 135.5 pounds. Her record, 7 wins with 5 losses, all but one of them coming by way of knockout or technical knockout. Training with Minnesota Martial Arts Academy and here to Kansas City from St. Louis Park, Minnesota. How about a big welcome for Kaitlin Young? Greg Franklin is your referee for this bout again scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Fighters, you've been given your instructions back in the locker room. I want a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Do I have any questions out of the red corner? Any questions out of the blue corner? Touch gloves, come out fighting.
You know, at the top of the telecast, Julie, we talked about you being the 2005 Hook and Shoot Women's Grand Prix Champion and what Jeff Osborne has done for the sport of women's MMA. Well, Kaitlin Young was the 2007 Hook and Shoot Women's Grand Prix Champ with 3 brutal knockouts in one night, including a highlight reel head kick KO of former Strikeforce Women's Bantamweight Champion Nisha Tate.
Yeah, when you talk about high athletic ability in this sport, Kaitlin Young tops the list. She's incredibly athletic, incredibly strong, and her movement is really, really sharp.
Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red. Young also known, of course, for being Gina Carano's opponent in the very first female MMA event on Primetime Network TV, Elite XC Primetime, back in May of 2008. And no feeling out process here, Mo.
Nah, man, she comes from the Diaz camp. She trains with them, and she goes out there and fights high volume, and we see it right now.
Talking about Leslie Smith in the blue tape around her wrist. Kaitlin Young also going at it. This is definitely Lovers affair, and there's the takedown. Young on her back now.
Wow, Kaitlin does a really nice hip switch there for an armbar attempt.
Both of these ladies known for their striking power. 6 of Young's 7 wins come via form of knockout. That's the most, by the way, on this Invicta card. The 6 wins via form of KO, while Leslie Smith, 2 of her 3 wins have come by way of a knockout or TKO.
Caitlin's hiking those legs up, trying for a high guard position.
There's the triangle. The body triangle, and just really wanting to control Smith here, Mo.
Trying to control her posture. Control her posture in the head, and they can't land any significant strikes.
I think Caitlin's looking for a position to get back to her feet. Oh, and
Smith not giving it her, but she does bounce up and delivers a knee as well. Flashes a jab, body kick.
That knee hurt her.
Yeah, if I were Caitlin, I would avoid more body kicks at the moment and start attacking the legs or the head. Oh, beautiful overhand.
There's a left, a nice jab, uppercut from Smith, who just swings wildly, gets caught with that right hand from Young. Oh, a nice body shot by Smith, and she continues to go to the body.
Caitlin tying up in the clinch. Her clinch is very, very strong. Let's see what she does with it.
Looks for the collar tie, maybe wants to go to the full tie plum, and now just delivering knees. Oh, a nice crossing elbow strike.
I'd like to see Smith try to take it to the ground again. On the other hand, this is really exciting, so maybe I don't want to see her take it to the ground.
Yeah, Smith is far more, she's far more effective when she's coming forward and throwing the volume.
Yeah,
but when she's backing up, she's just getting picked apart.
Yeah.
Just past the midway point of the opening round, it's been a very exciting start to this bantamweight bout between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith. No feeling out process. Smith coming forward with a right hand. There's a push kick.
Back left, Kaitlin, back left.
Nice kick.
Inside leg kick from Young.
It's really hard to walk the next day when you get kicked in the leg from Kaitlin Young.
So you're saying usually if you face Kaitlin Young, you're not going to be doing the Dougie later that night?
I wasn't.
Mo, do you do the Dougie?
Nah, man, we don't Dougie no more.
Oh, old school?
We hit the South Dallas swag. That's a new dance right now.
It's Ariel Helwani's favorite dance, the Dougie. There's a body kick from Young. And Smith comes back.
Smith is doing a really great job just being gritty and just getting right in there and getting the shots that she wants. And then,
oh wow. Great flurry from Smith, but then it's Young who stops it with a right and a left.
I like how Young's throwing combos and finishing with the leg kick.
Yeah, she's
or body kick.
Really beautifully timed Muay Thai.
But Smith nice. Again whims in with the left hook and a right hand as well. Not willing to give Young any room. You're just staying in the pocket.
I saw, you see the fake teeth, attention to teeth, to throw some shots.
Close the teeth, the equivalent of a leg jab.
Foot jab.
And foot jab, you're right.
Kaitlin does a good job of attacking on the left and then attacking on the right. Moving her strikes high to low, high to low.
The last time I checked, the foot is attached to the leg.
Not the same, because that's what...
No, you're right. The foot jab, how they use it, for sure.
One of the guys, a.k.a., his name's Jasper. He's a Thai fighter. He goes, foot jab, foot jab.
Nice. That's the teeth. One of the primary weapons in Muay Thai.
I think Smith's leg kicks would be a little bit more effective if she struck first. Nice flurry.
First, and she mixes it up with some kicks. There's the Thai plum from Young with the knee, but she gets back to the defense. So a very competitive opening round here.
Nice elbows.
The attack of the elbows at these ladies now. Neither one of them wants to give space.
A smorgasbord of strikes, and they are mixing it up here in round one. The final few seconds of what has been an electrifying start between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. They battle to the bell. The bell in round two is underway. And immediately Smith again taking the center of the cage, backing up Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red.
Smith has good head movement on that right hand, getting right out of the range of that hook there.
I like the pressure she's bringing. But she needs to keep going forward and have more confidence in her jab.
I absolutely agree with you. Kaitlin's winning the exchanges when she moves forward.
Smith coming off the loss to Gomez. Her only other loss was to Carrie Vera at Bellator Fighting Championships in May of 2009. Carrie Vera, of course, the wife of UFC veteran Brandon Vera. And Smith again mixing it up with punches and kicks. And Young responds in kind.
And Carrie Vera's a beast. And he did get it in the picture.
Wow. Smith's combinations, you know, they're flying, but they're hitting. And she's backing Young up. She's doing a really good job controlling the action there.
Great left from Young through the guard of Smith. Smith's good head movement, like you said, overhand right. Now into the clinch, Young. At close quarters.
Nice elbow on the exchange.
Nice knee on the exit from Smith.
Kaitlin looks to be bleeding a little bit from her nose, and looks like Smith's got a little mouse under her eye.
It's the vestiges of battle. It's been a very hard-hitting affair thus far.
I'm loving this fight.
Very good fight.
I want them to fight five rounds.
I like the jab that Young is throwing out there. Set the
pace. Good lateral movement there by Young. Good footwork. Just trying to stay away. Nicely done, evading that right hand from Smith. Smith, though, backs her up against the peg. Oh, and gets her head popped back like a Pez dispenser. But I like how Smith sneaks in that low leg kick while delivering up top.
Yeah, you know, she's doing a great job of it. She's low, high, just like Kaitlin was doing in the first round. It's...
But you see, I think that Smith is coming with that Margarito-type pace. Even though Young is landing shots, I can see that Smith, you can see her slowing, you know, Young slowing down a little bit.
I agree with you. I think that what you called earlier, when Young moves forward, she wins. Smith's the one doing the moving forward right now. Young's got really good lateral action and really good counter responses, but she needs to push forward. She has some hard knees. I'd like to see some of those midsection knees.
It looks like she's getting tired a little bit. Much better than a
counter right from Young. Lead left from the Minnesota Martial Arts Academy student again.
And those right hands are landing on Smith, though. She's doing that Terminator dance. Moving forward.
Oh, and again, Smith with the body. Beautiful right hand to the rib cage.
And that hurts. A Well, it hurts me at least. Maybe not her.
High head kick blocked by Young. 2 minutes remaining in the middle stanza.
Oh, nice setup.
And great left. Nice. Oh. Nothing but action here between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. Side leg kick from Smith. Left hand by Young.
You know,
there's the jab, double caught up. And the left head kick.
Yeah, these are the fights where they stand toe-to-toe and they just deliver and deliver over and over again. These are the fights. You're on the edge of your seat.
Tremendous excitement here between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. And Smith again mixing it up with kicks and a three-punch combination upstairs.
Yeah, Smith's really finding her range here. She's able to land multiple punches and multiple kicks now. But again, Kaitlin Young is, you know, her lateral motion is what's working very effectively for her. I wish she would capitalize on some of the angles she's getting.
Well, it's interesting that Smith works at Team Caesar Gracie, and her volume of punching and striking very similar to that of the Diaz brothers.
I like to see her go to the body a little more.
Yeah, she's very effective with the body work. And meanwhile, Kaitlin Young backing up, but also delivering her fair share. There's that overhand right.
Nice body kick.
Very effective with the kicks and the punches, but Young again stops her with that straight right hand. There's the left from Smith. Body kick from Young. 30 seconds left in another entertaining round. Outside leg kick to the lead leg administered by Young. Smith, Young intercepts her. It looked like Smith was going to deliver a left kick, and Young came upstairs with a punch. Final 10 seconds of the second stanza. Switch kick from Smith.
This is kind of a volume versus power.
Good point. Very well said. And there it is, the end of the round. Volume versus power. If you think he reminds you of Rich Franklin, well, that's because it's his brother. Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red.
Smith came running into the action there. She is ready to go right now.
These two athletes putting it all on the line here in the third and final round. A striker's gallery here. There's a firing off at every angle, using every weapon, punches and kicks.
Nice kick right there.
And a body kick from
that
Smith.
Yeah. Kind of you can
yeah, wants to tenderize that lead leg and then goes upstairs under the armpit. Right hand, and you're right, Kaitlin Young now trying to build off this momentum, but Leslie Smith, this is a firefight!
She switched to southpaw for a second, too. Oh, right
hand. Oh, overhand hit. Oh, wow.
Nice sprawl. Young. Nice sprawl. Nice
Young.
Getting those body shots against her, though, like you guys said, that's going to hurt.
So Young looking for the takedown, but the good takedown defense here by Leslie Smith. Some punches to the body. Now it looks like there may be, blood. Kaitlin Young must be cut. His blood is on the leg of Leslie Smith.
But she did a smart thing by switching out to a single leg.
Yeah, going out.
Oh, now a smart.
Oh, very well. Oh,
and Smith lands
Smith
on top.
Ends up in top position. Oh, Kaitlin trying for an armbar attempt there.
These two ladies are going at it like a dentist and a carpenter, tooth and nail, baby!
Now, this is great body work. Someone like, you know, Eddie Alvarez or people, you know, guys from Philly, they love body. They love going the body in.
Speaking of the guys from Philly, I don't know if B-Hop and Dawson can provide us with action like this, Mo.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me, Kaitlin trying for an armbar. Young trying for an armbar right now. Locks her legs together, though. I feel like if she unlocked her legs and hikes them down, she'd be able to get a little more leverage or turn and go belly down. Oh, going for the triangle now.
Transitioning to the triangle.
Smith defending it.
And great job by Smith, who ends up in cross-side position.
Oh, my gosh, going for an armbar of her own. Good
Lord,
this is
awesome. Look at her putting that left leg over the face. That's awesome.
Wow. Give these ladies lots of money.
Whoa. Leslie Smith
incredible.
And Young escaping into open guard. The fans here in Kansas City on Fuego, the action hot and heavy.
Kaitlin Young looking to get her ground and pound established now. I know she wants a good top position.
What a
fight. Oh, looking for the knee on the way out. Nicely done.
Young with the cut over her left eye.
Smith doesn't care. She's just going to keep coming forward.
Flashing the jab. Smith misses with the overhand right. Young stays in the pocket, flashes the left hand.
You people watching from home, women can fight.
That they can.
Hey, from now on, I'm going to start calling Leslie Smith Lil Diaz. Because Lil Diaz is fighting just like
Lil Diaz. Wow, nice right hand from Young.
Lead right from Young. Smith coming forward. Nice. 1-2 combination of her own. There's a body kick from Smith. Oh. And a left hand upstairs. Inside leg kick from the bloodied Young.
Man, look at her leg. She has got a big welt on that leg. I would like to see Kaitlin working even more leg kicks this fight.
We were treated to a barn burner between Sara Kaufman and Alexis Davis on the last Strike Force preliminary card. And Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith looking to give them a run for their money here on the first Invicta Fighting Championships event. A minute and a half left in the fight.
Nice right hand.
Overhand right from Smith.
Kaitlin looking to time her shots a little bit here. I think she really wants to hit a really strong
shot. Oh, she almost ducked into an uppercut from Smith.
Nice.
Body kick from Young, both of them.
They're going to have some sore ribs in the morning.
Giving as good as they are getting. Punch kick combination from Young. Final 60 seconds of what has been a spirited affair between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith. What do they have left for us here in the final 53 seconds of this incredible fight?
This is amazing.
I'm speechless.
I know a lot of people watching wish I were. Smith.
Nice kick.
And another kick. Oh, and that hurts. That hurts Smith. She's limping now. Smith is in pain.
Young hits it again.
The determination.
It hurt her earlier this round, too.
And Young goes upstairs with the right hand. Final 22 seconds. Look at Smith still unloading a kick.
Now she's walking a little bit more tenderly, but she's not going to give up any ground there.
Both of these phenomenal athletes leaving every ounce of their fighting spirit inside the cage. The final 10 seconds of what has been a phenomenal fight.
The best fight I've seen in a long time.
Smith and Young are going at it till the final bell. And Invicta FC 1 has arrived.
Great fight. Great.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, all you can ever ask of a professional athlete is that they leave it all on their chosen field of battle. And these two did that for you tonight at Invicta FC.
Bringing the crowd to their feet.
We turn it over to the judges. And here's what they tell us. Judge Kevin Champion scores the bout 29-28, blue corner. Judge Henry Geary scores the bout 29-28, red corner. And Judge Victoria Millipent scores the bout 29-29, a draw.
Whoa,
rematch.
Hey, Shannon and Janet, Invicta FC 2, I think we already have one fight. A rematch between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith is in order. And while they both are maybe shocked by the outcome, I think the fans
Who
are the
like
biggest
to
winners.
See this one again?
Yeah, no doubt.
I see this one again every day. I have to train.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you lucky enough to be with us here in Memorial Hall in Kansas City, I want those watching around the globe via the World Wide Web at InvictaFC.com to hear you. When I ask you, Kansas City, can you feel it? It is time for your main event of the evening. Introducing first, the fighter standing on my right and fighting from the blue corner. Arguably the top female wrestler in all of MMA. She proved that when she represented the United States of America at the Athens 2004 Olympic Games and brought back the silver medal. At 5 feet 5 inches tall, she weighed in at 135.5 pounds. Her record, a perfect 5 wins with no losses. Training at Revolution MMA and Limestone Wrestling, she's here tonight in Kansas City, fighting out of Gaffney, South Carolina. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Sara McMann. Her opponent tonight, no doubt, one of the most skilled submission artists in all of MMA today. Trained in catch wrestling and also jiu-jitsu, the winner of 8 of her last 10 fights. At 5 feet, 7 inches tall, she weighed in at 133 and one half pounds. Her professional record, 14 wins with 6 losses. She trains at CSW and Next Edge Academy of Martial Arts and is here tonight from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Ladies and gentlemen, Shayna, the Queen of Spain's Baszler. Big John McCarthy, your referee for about scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Ladies, protect yourself at all times and obey my commands at all times. If you want to touch gloves, touch them now. Fight clean, fight hard. Good luck.
We are scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Kansas City, the world is watching. Let them hear ya!
Invicta Fighting Championships 2 main event, Shayna Baszler. With the red tape around her gloves, Olympic silver medalist, the undefeated Sara McMann with blue tape around her gloves, Big John McCarthy, the man in the middle, calling for the bell, and we are underway. The winner will fight October 6th back here at Memorial Hall for the first ever Invicta FC Bantamweight Championship. Quick striking exchange. Right hand to the sternum area by McMann. Outside leg kick by McMann, darting in and out. Body kick by Baszler. So some good stand-up on display early on.
Absolutely. She's staying pretty composed in all this. You know, McMahon's definitely throwing some power shots at her, and Baszler's kind of staying calm, finding her shots. But just looking at them, they look like, I mean, McMahon looks like she has quite the size on Baszler in terms of her legs and stuff like that. I'm not trying to, you know, comment too much on physicality, but she looks like she might have a pretty hard power shot that Baszler's taking there.
One thing Baszler does have is the length and the reach and the experience. You know, she looks composed. You see Sarah McMahon wasting a lot of motion, fainting, and Baszler's just sitting there knowing she's seen everything. She's seen everything to see, and she's just sitting there waiting to land her shot. She landed the body kick earlier and a few good punches, so it's, so far it's pretty even.
McMahon looking to work the body, darting in, attacking the body with the lefts and the rights. Baszler, very focused, very compact, just sitting in the stance, catches it with the right hand, downstairs with the outside leg kick.
The center of the ring, Shayna, on the center of the ring.
Josh Barnett in Baszler's corner, imploring her to keep the center of the ring.
Shayna looks very, she looks very composed and settled. You know, she's not wasting too much motion. She sees everything coming. Sara needs to go ahead and settle down if she wants to land anything effective, because she's just wasting a lot of motion, jumping around.
Take the center of the ring, don't give it back to her.
Body kick by Baszler.
Relax.
A lot of nervous energy seems to be coursing through the veins of Sara McMahon, but still looking for an opening. Oh, and there she has a beautiful overhand right by McMahon. And Baszler closes the gap, has the underhooks, delivers some knees, and McMahon delivers a short knee, and on the exit, body kick from Baszler.
Hands up, chin down. Good break, Shayna. Stay on your toes. Keep that left up. Relax. Keep those eyes open. Be ready with those hands.
Sara needs to establish a jab if she wants to land that right hand again.
I like how Shayna's fading to her left and letting the attack come and then countering right off of it. It's working very well for her right now.
Nice right hand.
Good counter right by McMahon. Baszler moving forward.
Baszler's jab is landing pretty clean. You know, I'm very impressed.
Body kick, but countered by McMahon. Baszler listening to her coach, Josh Barnett, has her chin down, hands high. Oh, nice counter right there.
Look at Baszler's posture. You see her chin's kind of hidden behind her left shoulder. And she's right there. She has a jab hand ready to pop. Yep.
Trains her Muay Thai under the Thai Boxing Association of America, Ajahn Chai Sarasuti. I believe awarded her instructorship a couple years ago.
Outside leg kick by McMahon. Bounces away. Baszler just remains very focused, just walking down McMahon. Minute 22, there's a quick exchange. Baszler looking to stick the jab.
Sara, she doesn't look relaxed at all. She looks too tense. I'd like to see her get a takedown just to mix things up. Keep Baszler guessing. A takedown would keep Baszler worrying about, you know, is she going to take me down? Not one takedown attempt.
Waiting in with the strikes. Final minute of the opening round.
I know that McMann was wanting to test out her her striking skills a little bit more in this fight.
She's doing just that.
She sure is. You know, she's avoided the takedown up until this point, and now she's in the position where she gets a lot of body slams. So let's see what Baszler's defense has.
McMann looking for that takedown.
You step between the leg. What she should do is get her left leg, step the left leg in between Baszler's legs, and do that corkscrew. Turn, pull her, and turn
gable
her
grip.
To her right. Yeah, off the gable grip.
15 seconds left in the opening round. This is the main event of Invicta FC 2, Shayna Baszler. Sara McMann.
Excuse me. I like this fight right now. This is exciting. We're seeing McMahon. Ooh.
Right up, right shot to the body. Both of them hitting each other's body at the bell. The bell in round two, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. The main event of Invicta FC 2, Shayna Baszler and Sara McMann here at Memorial Hall in Kansas City, Kansas. Mauro Ranallo along with Julie Ketsey and King Mo. Hope you're enjoying the action wherever you may be watching on InvictaFC.com.
Off the kick, I like how Baszler's throwing that jab right as the kick lands.
And I think she hurt that nose because McMahon's touched it a couple times now.
Josh Barnett saying, always step to the center, make McMahon engage. And McMahon coming forward, and there's a punch kick combination and a side kick from Baszler.
And you see in Baszler's movement, she's taking half-inch steps. Not too much, just a little bit, just to stay in the distance to land her shots and get out the way, invade. And you see her get countered right there at the right hand, and she swings wildly. Sarah needs to settle down. She needs to settle down and have confidence to stand up and have confidence in her takedowns.
Keep pumping that jab, even if it's to get her to react. Shayna. She's coming straight forward. Have it ready.
And there's the first takedown off the kick by Baszler. So McMahon counters it, and now Baszler working the rubber guard. Of course, a catch wrestling specialist.
Good. Keep working. Watch the elbow.
And catch wrestling in more violent form, some say. If you ask Josh Barnett of the great shooters back in the day, you know, a very violent form of submission fighting. They call BJJ the gentle art, not so much catch wrestling.
Catch wrestling, man, back in the day, they said you could fish hook and whatever, you know, anything goes. And, you know.
Oh.
Nice elbow from
Baszler looking for the heel.
The leg.
Scramble here in round two.
Josh Barnett calling her to sit and attack the ankle.
Hammer fist from the bottom by McMahon. Baszler looking for that ankle. Toe hold now. Might even turn it into a knee bar. It's a very precarious moment here. Midway through the round in the fight. McMahon, meanwhile, busy. Off her back now. Baszler looking at Josh Barnett for instruction.
This is confidence right here and relaxation. I'll tell you this, I've trained with Barnett, and he has some crazy, nasty submissions. He looks to break everything he can get his hands on.
Well, in the footsteps of Carl Gotch and Billy Robinson.
I'm having a hard time not being a fan right now of what's going on.
McMahon desperately trying to, you know, at least show that she's trying to be effective from her back, but it's
take it.
Position before submission. Baszler looking for that here in round two.
You can't punch the spine. You gotta be careful. Come on.
Nice escape by McMahon.
Knee pulled out, though. Now it's a jockey for top position. And I like how McMahon's
great scramble. Minute and a half left in the second round. The fans here enjoying this action.
This is amazing.
McMahon should ignore the punching part and look to keep on scrambling with it, because sometimes when you're in a scramble, a punch will just keep you one step behind.
Baszler looking to pass the guard. A minute 11 left in the second stanza. Great action here between Shayna Baszler and Sara McMahon.
Yeah.
And there's the guard pass.
This is too much fun, guys. I love it.
60 seconds left. Wow. Nice work by Shayna Baszler.
Counted the Kimura attempt by Sara Mann. Now, Sara Mann is good here. She's good here. She has to get hand control and come to her feet.
Oh, wow. And Shayna responds by kicking on the way up. Wow.
40 seconds left in the second round. The crowd loving every second. McMann again a little wild with the striking, going to the body, getting picked off by Baszler.
A little wardrobe malfunction.
30 seconds, Shayna.
My goodness.
And McMann just pulling out all the stops, coming in with her lefts and rights, but a kick by Baszler keeps her honest. 15 seconds left in the round. Good head movement by Baszler to avoid the striking attack of McMann. Invicta FC 2, bantamweight main event, Baszler and McMann. Round 3 coming up with McMann getting Baszler's back at the bell. Submission artists, they touch gloves, and we are set for the third and final round of the Invicta FC 2 main event.
I'm expecting McMann to just fire off some takedowns right now. I think she'll want to secure this round and try for a finish as soon as possible.
McMann misses with the lead right uppercut.
And for those people watching, that's one thing you don't do. You do not lead with the uppercut because you'll get countered by a clean left hook. So all those beginner fighters out there, never lead with the uppercut. Start off with the jab and then throw your uppercut or look to counter with the uppercut.
Nice sportsmanship in there with a mistimed punch to the back of the head.
Josh Barnett saying to Baszler, she moves every time you jab, Shayna. And going off of what you said, Mo, it's all about establishing the jab.
Set that jab up and throw that long right.
Oh, a power punch from McMann. Punch
it to the wind.
I'm not going to lie, she's flurried, but I don't know how many of those punches landed.
Right. She's trying, but they're not finding the distance. Baszler doing a good job of avoiding much of the offense of Sara McMann here in round 3. And Baszler's, the veteran, has had the composure and the poise throughout the fight.
Baszler lands a short left hook in that exchange right there. Counter. I just wish Sara would just loosen up and just relax.
Oh,
nice takedown.
Single leg in the pipe. Oh, wow. She's going to rack up some points this way. That's nice.
Well, she can try rack up points, but, you know, that's not two. You can't
finish it, yeah.
Freestyle's 1 point, and collegiate is 2, and then I could give that to you in MMA. But it's a nice way to mix things up. So I like that there.
Well, our friends at I Judge Fights tweeting us that the consensus at the site has it 19-19 after 2 rounds. So that's how close our viewers on InvictaFC.com or those playing along with iJudge Fights see it. So a very close fight here with 2 minutes and 43 seconds left in the final round.
Baszler's corner is calling for her to jab forward now, move forward. She's hitting that nice angle, though, when McMann flurries. Like, she's really doing a good job of
now it comes down to the guys as we pass the midway point of the third round. Who wants it more? Mm-hmm. The offense has to be picked up now, right?
You gotta take the risk, but the one thing about Sara Mann, I'm not liking is how she's running with her punches.
She's got her back, though, right away after picking up the single. Right. McMann now with the left hand against the face of Baszler. Baszler's got the post with her right hand, but eating those lefts.
Oh, she knocked her mouthpiece out. Can't really stop in the middle of this kind of action, though.
And Big John McCarthy picks it up, letting the action continue. Less than 2 minutes left in the fight. Josh Barnett saying it best for Baszler. You've got 2 minutes to win this fight. Sir McMahon's corner probably feeling the same way with a minute, 45 seconds left in this tilt. And the Queen of Spades chant emerging. For Shayna Baszler.
This is the time when that physicality, you know, is starting to count. Sarah's so strong inside the clinch like that. And she's looking to put Shayna back on her back.
A minute 20 left in the fight. McMann has Baszler pinned up along the fence. This fight very much up for grabs. The winner again already promised. An opportunity to vie for the first ever Invicta FC Bantamweight Championship coming up October 6th here in Memorial Hall, Kansas City, Kansas. Earlier tonight, Shannon Knapp, Invicta FC president, announcing an atomweight title fight as well. But now, with 50 seconds left, who wants this fight more?
Right now, if you take a score on this round, I feel like Sara McMann has advantage off the takedown, the positioning, but not much of damage was done, so anything can happen in this last 40 seconds.
And there is a quick break to wash out the mouthpiece and immediately puts back in, and here we go. Final 30 seconds of the main event for Invicta FC 2. Shayna Baszler, Sara McMann.
Wow.
Straight right by McMann. Body kick by Baszler. Body shots from McMann. Leg kick from McMann into the final few seconds of this main event. Looks like we're headed to the judges' scorecards in Kansas City, Kansas. Final 10 seconds. And now in the focus, striking.
Wow.
McMann.
Oh, my God. Baszler in top position. Oh.
What a finish for the Queen of Spades.
Wow.
And that very much
could
have done it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, how about it, Kansas City? There's your main event. Fifteen hard-fought minutes, and we turn it over to the judges' scorecard. They hand us back, once again, a unanimous decision. Judge Clifton scores the bout 29-28. Judge Gary, 30-27. And Judge Pence, 29-28, all for your winner. Fighting out of the blue corner, Sara McMann.
Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. With a background in jiu-jitsu and boxing, she stands 5 feet, 3 inches tall. Weighing in at the limit, 106 pounds even. She brings a professional record that stands 7 victories and 5 defeats. Fighting out of Lakewood, Colorado, here is Lacey, the lady. And next, her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. Her style, karate and jiu-jitsu. Also standing 5 feet 3 inches tall, she too weighed in at the limit, 106 pounds even. Her professional record, outstanding with 9 victories and just 3 defeats. Fighting out of, representing Albuquerque, New Mexico, here is the karate hottie, Michelle. Michelle Drake Browning.
For those of you who love to part with your hard-earned money, according to our buddy at Fight Odds, Nick Kalikas, Michelle Waterson is at minus 345, Lacey Schuckman at plus 255 for this atomweight contest. Michelle Drake Browning, the referee, the bell, and round one. Waterson with the red tape around her gloves, Schuckman with the blue tape, Schuckman in the pink and black, Waterson in the black and white. Leg kick by Waterson. Circles away from the cage, takes the center of the cage now. That kick was trapped by Schuckman.
We can hear the instructions from Lacey's corner. Oh, big flurry.
Coming forward, but the kick catches her from Waterson now. Attacking the body with those right hands. Schuckman scoops her up and takes her down.
Nice double leg takedown. Now she's in trouble with the guillotine. She's getting through the guillotine.
I think she's leveraging it pretty well right there, though.
Might bring that knee through, but now she's good.
Michelle abandoned the guillotine right there.
Now a full mount achieved by Schuckman on Waterson. And Waterson surrenders her back early in round one, just past the 1 minute mark. Schuckman now driving in those hammer fists with her right hand. And looking for the rear naked choke, flattening out the karate hottie here in the opening round.
I can't see the angle that. I don't think her right arm sunk all the way in under the chin yet, but I do think she's delivering some pretty hard blows there.
Schuckman's husband screaming for hammer fists. Meanwhile, she's sliding that right arm underneath the chin of Waterson.
Oh,
hurtling up here.
Almost has it.
Yeah, it looks like it's under the chin now. It's like she's gonna, I would flatten her out at that point. Michelle's doing a good job of facing up like that, but that, it looks like.
She can go out the back door. She can keep on, now she's readjusting.
Yeah, Michelle fights hands right here. She abandoned the choke.
Releases the grip.
This is high level right here, guys.
And now Waterson may be going back to her back. Schuckman still top position.
Waterson needs to do a hard shrimp right there and reestablish a half guard or guard position. She's going to be in trouble with some more ground and pound there. And there's that shrimp happening there. She's got to push out just a little bit harder. Lacey's doing a good job of using her muscle, using her strength. Michelle shrimps to half guard.
Her husband telling her that her knee in half guard needs to be heavy. Can you elucidate, Julia, what that means?
Well, I think that her hips are a little high there, and she's not going to be able to establish good ground and pound from that position, which is probably what they're trying to accomplish right here with her size. It looks like she's actually trying to get a key lock right there.
Americana.
Yeah, the top, will wrist lock the Americana.
But she'll have to get her leg from the half guard.
Yeah. Michelle really shouldn't be hitting the body with that. Yeah, she should be pushing on the hips and trying to reestablish a better position.
2 minutes left in the opening round.
Or using her right arm to get in between the legs.
Absolutely.
To look for a sweep.
Waterson striking from the bottom has survived perilous position, survived the submission attempt, but right now needs to try her best to escape while Schuckman controls from top position. A minute 42 left now, looking to her corner and her husband for additional instruction is the Lady Lacey Schuckman. He's calling for elbow strikes.
So goes back to the re-guard, jumps up to high guard there.
So Waterson.
Elbows from the bottom.
High guard on Schuckman. Schuckman stacking her up. Waterson looking for the arm bar. Waterson looking for the arm bar with a minute 18 left in the first round.
It looks like she lost the hand a little bit. Looks like Schuckman's going to be able to get her elbow out there. But
this is a crazy scramble right here.
What a reversal of positions.
The person with the head higher will win the scramble.
Yeah.
And look at this. Waterson has turned the tables on Schuckman. Yeah. Michelle Waterson back on her feet. Kicking at the legs of Schuckman. Schuckman back up to a base. So in the final minute, both Schuckman and Waterson on their feet, much to the delight of the crowd here in Kansas City.
Oh, wow.
Right hand from Waterson, but again, Schuckman charges forward and wants to take her back to the canvas right above us here.
Schuckman is just a grinder.
Yeah,
strong.
It's cross-facing to get better position and push her hips to the side. But she is putting herself in a position to get kneed right there. She's doing a great job cross-facing, though, to release her head.
15 seconds left in the round. Waterson trying to pummel, pinned up along the cage by Schuckman. Final seconds. Waterson survived the turbulent waters, but a great start by Lacey Schuckman here in the opening round.
Great round up there. Great round.
And now here in round two, they'll get it going again. Invicta FC 3 action. How'd you score that first round? I know you're a teammate.
I think that was Schuckman's round for sure.
Mo, you concur?
Wow.
I co-sign that.
And look at Waterson coming out much more aggressively with the knee strikes. Knee to the back of the leg. Schuckman responds in kind.
And Schuckman is hard-nosed.
Yeah, she is. I didn't see that as a low right leg kick. I saw that as a high left kick. Maybe they have a code. that's pretty cool.
And the other right leg.
Yeah.
We're looking for Waterson to counter those kicks with no setups, with some right type of right hand or left hook.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Doing a good job of avoiding the kicks thus far from the center of the cage. Responds with a low outside leg kick of her own, does the karate hottie. 1 minute gone here in the second round. Oh, a bleak kick.
A Winkle John special.
Winkle John.
Oh, axe kick, but it gives up the single.
But she gets caught.
And now still swinging away is Waterson with her left arm as the kick was caught by Schuckman, who has pinned her along the fence again. Waterson good balance, did, though, by Waterson.
Yeah, great job avoiding or getting out of that treetop position, but she's still in a little bit of danger here of that high crotch, I think. Is that right, Mo?
It's a modified, it's like a single leg right there, but it's very high single leg in the crotch region.
Ladies doing a great job of cross-facing. You know, it's a fight for head position a lot of the time, and they're both fighting for that. Oh,
wow,
takedown.
And Schuckman goes for the takedown, but it's Waterson that ends up on her back going for the choke.
And right here, I think Waterson really needs to emphasize breaking her down, because with the bigger or the stronger fighter, like, oh, looks like she has that. Is that under the chin? I can't see from this. Oh, no, it's not.
But Waterson coming off a rear naked choke win in her last fight against Diana Rayo. Known as a finisher.
Schuckman's corner is calling for a backdoor escape because Waterson's hips are high.
The underhook right there killed that. Made Schuckman go flat to her back. Now it's a whole different game. Schuckman needs to shrimp, create distance with her hips and her hands. With her being her flat in her back, she will not get into her feet unless she creates some type of angle with her hips.
Yeah. 8 of Waterson's 9 wins have come inside the distance, including a flying armbar against Rosary Califano.
They're calling for those heel chops.
Old school heel strikes.
Hoyt's Gracie style.
Mm-hmm.
Waterson needs to watch out, actually, for a sweep right here. Her hips are low, but her left leg is a little bit too extended, I think. She needs to watch, you know, being tipped right over. But Lacey's hands are occupied with Waterson's head. So I don't know if she's actually going to try for any of those.
Well, reversal of fortunes here in the second round, though, after Waterson was in tough against Schuckman in that opening round. Waterson has definitely asserted herself here in the second frame from top position.
Now, Waterson needs to, you know, posture up to do more damage these shots. Sit back. Hand fight and land some good elbows and some good punches. Maybe work the body some, but in this situation right here, there's nothing effective being landed.
Absolutely. She needs to get a good posture here and get some of those elbows going.
Battering the body with the left hand is the karate hottie. Schuckman has her right knee up. Trying to work, well, has the half guard closed now. Doesn't allow Waterson to achieve mount. A minute left in the round.
Waterson needs to watch being swept. She's still a little bit high on her hips there, I think. She's doing nice little shoulder butts there. That's kind of fun. Lacey's doing a great job of breaking that posture down, though, making it very hard to launch an effective striking campaign against the head.
Yeah, she's controlling Waterson's head. Oh, open guard, now the guard. Full guard by Schuckman. 30 seconds remaining in the round. If the first round was Schuckman's, the second round looks like it's going to go to the karate hottie. If it stays this way, heel strikes from Schuckman. Just wanting to control Waterson, not allow her to posture up or deliver any kind of ground and pound or transition to a submission attempt. Waterson. Now she's postured up, and Waterson looking to rain down some blows. Final 10 seconds. Waterson with a wide base. There's some ground and pounds. Piston-like
heavy
white hands from the karate hottie.
Heavy hands. She gets kicked away on her booty at the end.
A great round is in the books. Both of them quick.
And do what you came here to do.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This is the third and final round.
What a fight so far, guys.
According to our unofficial scorecard, the fight hangs in the balance. The bell in round 3 of this atomweight tilt underway between Michelle Waterson and Lacey Schuckman. Waterson in the black and white, Schuckman in the pink and black.
They both look pretty fresh, too.
High altitude, ladies.
Conditioning should not be an issue when you train in Albuquerque, New Mexico, or Colorado. Straight right by Waterson.
Still trying to figure out what tree trunk is. I think it's a kick.
Schuckman's husband doing his own play-by-play.
I know, right? think there's a difference between running and effective movement, but.
Effective aggression.
Yeah. I'd like to see some strikes from either one of them at this point. Yeah.
Oh, spinning head kick by Waterson. There's the karate background. There's a vicious leg kick to the lead leg of Schuckman. So Watterson's definitely found her second win here after a tough first round. Hooked the second round and off to a good start here in round three. Schuckman trying to walk her down.
This is strength versus speed right here.
Absolutely. A lot of emotion out of the corner there. You know, I think that Waterson's doing a good job being patient, but I think Lacey's also doing a very good job of just setting up what she wants to do. Unfortunately, Waterson's just out of the way when Lacey settles in.
Her husband wants Schuckman to let it go, and here she comes in with a flurry of strikes as Waterson against the fence. Waterson pummeling now has overhook, trying to keep the separation, slides away, knee to the belly by Waterson as she circles away from the fence.
I'd like to see either one of them get another takedown and we can see some of those ground scrambles again.
You would think there would be a sense of urgency on each of their part with the way the fight is unfolded. As we near the midway point of the final stanza, Fainton, who fakes from each. Waterson, lots of energy coursing through her veins, setting up in the center of the cage. There's that flip kick.
I think both of them really like to kick. They're just waiting for the opportunity.
There's an inside leg kick from Schuckman, and an outside leg kick, and a left kick comes in to the clinch. Looks for the takedown. Waterson has her pinned up against the fence now, avoiding the takedown, but there the trip takedown attempt by Schuckman doesn't work.
Schuckman's putting herself in a good position, and Michelle is very wisely not reaching over the head. Her legs are close together.
Good takedown defense by Waterson. Schuckman's hubby calling for the foot stomp. She gets it. Never seen anyone tap out of foot. Oh, reverse elbows. Back elbows from Waterson as Schuckman tries for the takedown, perseveres, and gets a very crucial takedown here with a minute 34 left. High guard again by Waterson momentarily. 90 seconds left in the fight.
I think at this point.
You're a coach, you're a psychologist, you have to play all kinds of roles in the corner. Nice reversal here by Waterson. What a
top position. At this point, she better pick up that pace and she better start. Yeah.
Body triangle by Waterson.
She really wants that armbar, it looks like.
Less than a minute remaining in the fight. The sweep by Waterson. Looking for the submission now, maybe going for the triangle from the bottom. Now just a high guard. 45 seconds left. Back and forth affair.
Oh, reaching under the leg like that actually gave her the space to get up, I think.
Very close fight. It still could be anybody's scrap with 30 seconds left. Schuckman fires off the left hand.
Yeah, not a good idea to lead with a kick there. She should put some hands. There you go. Put some hands in front of her.
Oh, left hand kick by Waterson. Kick by Waterson and a left kick. Final 10 seconds. Who wants it more?
Oh,
front kick by Waterson. Schuckman comes in with the clinch. Has her up against the fence. We are off to the judges' scorecards in this exciting atomweight affair.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three exciting rounds in the cage, we go to the scorecards one more time. Kansas City, let's hear it for these two atomweight warriors. What an effort out of both of them. Here are the judges' scoring totals. Judge Victoria Miller Pence has it 29-28 for Schuckman. Judge Henry Gary 29-28 Waterson. And Judge Kevin Champion scores it 29-28. Your winner by split decision, the Karate Hottie, Michelle Waterson.
Michelle Waterson picks up a razor-thin split decision.
decision win over Lacey Schuckman.